So in the first chapter, we created a base SSH login user restricted, and then in the second chapter, we basically extended that module to also support conditionally local restricted local login users, and thus that was just a base because it doesn't work as is, because we basically don't allow the users to execute generic binaries, because we need to see what binaries are actually executed and then determine whether we should confine them or not. So I'm going to first take care of, because from now on it's things are getting ugly. Let me just clarify that first. Cat home my login user and then SSH and then out, and I'm just basically getting the key and adding that key to my normal login. So that's basically Dominic, and that's not with a capital D, and also not with a S, and then nano that, and then paste it in there. Oh, it was already in there. Anyway, so okay, save that. And now basically I'm going to start by logging in remotely. So C and then SSH Dominic at SSH netkb info ID. Oops, not if ID. So yeah, I'm unconfined in this thing. So I'm going to be doing my stuff from here now. Where is my login user? So cd my login user. All right. Because we're going to basically have to add some support now for XDM, GDM in this case. So exit. Exit. So let's just think about that for a while. So basically, GDM is another login program, just like the login program is used for the local logins, and SSHD is a login program via for SSH. So basically we need to implement that same idea, but then for XDM, to allow this user to log in via the GDM. Now this is not something I do every day, but we can just basically I think start by just using that same idea. So I'll just my login user TE. So just like the enable SSH login, or let's just say the local login, we can basically add one, or also the declaration of course for GDM or XDM. So paste that in and then just call that my login user enable, and then I'll just call it XDM login. And that's probably XDMT. XDMT. Oh, yeah, XDMT. Probably, I'm not sure. To be honest, it's going to require some testing, and just like I said, it's probably getting really ugly right now. Basically that's that. And let's have a look at there's going to be slight difference. So I took a look at the policy, and turns out that Xserver basically runs the user DOM accession spec DOM trans all users, and then user DOM spec DOM trans all users basically gives me the following. So XDM, so we need to basically allow that stuff. I'll just add that here, I guess. So basically it's here my login user T instead of user domain. And then XDMT instead of parameter one or variable one. And then basically get rid of the read write FIFO file params. And we'll just use this for that. Keep it raw instead of using macros. Alrighty, so what else do we have? So use the main. So and then it goes on to call the Xserver accession spec DOM trans, which is specified here, and that one calls the domain trans, which is in the MISC patterns. And then let's look for the domain trans. And that was, let's see, let's have a look again, domain trans. Where is the domain trans? Oh, it was basically renamed. So it's the domain transition pattern. So this one here. So we need to add that as well. So here we have. And then I also need to require the accession exactee type, and then basically allow accession exactee, and then I guess XDM. And this is all already allowed, so I don't really have to add that one. XDM, oops. XDM is transitioning to my login user T. And then XDM, don't audit my login user T. Now, in theory, this should be it, and of course in practice it will be far from it. Make app user share as a Linux deval make file. It builds, so that's the start. Sudo as a module my login user pp, and then the password. for that. And then basically after this, if this builds and loads and does, then we need to take care of default contexts. Basically PAM needs to tell XDM which context XDM should transition to when the user logs in. So that's basically sudo shell, I guess, or actually sudo nano. Well, actually, let's just shell it. CD etc as in Linux, or actually let's just ls it, because eventually I'm going to be there back here anyways. Targeted context users, and then just get the xcast u, xcast u, to see the entry. So basically here you have that system role xdmt and then the default context. Copy that, and then just basically nano my login user u. And then just add that in there and adjust that to reflect our user, my login user, my login user, and that's it. Now, in theory, this should be it, but in practice, it's going to be far from it. But let's just play with it a little bit. Log out. So the system is in enforcing mode, but the user itself is in permissive mode. So just so that you are aware of that. Let's click it, and then now we are already having an issue here. Would you like to enter a security context? For just for testing this role. So we'll say my login user R. Cannot make remove entry for the specified session. So let's just have a look at what everything else. I'll search MAVCTS recent. No matches. Less till and 200 var log audit audit.log. What we have here, my login user XDM. Doesn't actually tell me much. Let's have a look at the default context, my login user XDM. Nano my login user T. So what could be wrong? Oh, I know what's wrong. We forgot to set the boolean. Get SA bool. Grab my login user. That's one thing. We should start by setting the boolean to allow the actual set se bool p to allow the actual transition on. So else it doesn't work. It probably won't work even with this, because that would be too easy. But at least this should be set. So try again. Cannot make. Let's see if we have any other stuff right now. Here we have a lot of stuff. Here we have a lot of stuff already. So let's just out it to allow that. And I thought the my login user was actually permissive, to be honest. It is permissive, so that means that it's not actually denied. But something is still wrong, because the actual login doesn't happen. OAuth mavcts recent added to allow. Yeah, we have the key create stuff that we forgot. The last line there, because we know that the my login user is permissive, so it's not. That's not actually blocking, but the XDM trying to create the user key is actually not allowed, because XDM is not permissive, I guess. And it's, I thought XDM was unconfined domain, but I guess not. That's only, that's good, that's no problem, but let's just create that. So the same as the other, with the other domains where they create these keys, these user keys, we need to do the same. And that's this basically for the login user. We're going to do that for XDM. So XDM login, I will just add that rule here. And then XDM is allowed to create the user keys. XDM build. Okay, so it looks like I'm going to have to. Oh, actually, I'll just do it as root. Who cares? Make f user share as Linux. Dev make file, and then not sudo, because I'm root already. As in module e my login user pp. But you can already see what it's trying to do here. And that's the first thing. I should probably already take care of that, but so for example, user temp. So I'll just 15 15 35, and then grab user temp t. See what's happening there. See, you already have this num keyring daemon, which is trying to basically create stuff in the temp directory. So we need to basically already take care of that shit. Now, fortunately, that already has a type. So here it's, things already start getting really messy already. So let's just look at as you manage context list and then grep for keyring, and it's as you manage, not as you module. Because we need to actually confine the that stuff. So here it is, and it already has a type. So basically, what we need to do is create policy. So we just need to basically create policy. And we're going to do it the ugly way. So I'm basically all the way below, going to make a session gnome keyring daemon. So I'm going to create a new type my login user. GTKRD, so abbreviation for GNOME Keyring Daemon, and then basically domain entry file or domain type first Axia. By making it a domain type, we're already making it really ugly. So should we make it a domain? I don't think we should. But actually we must. We must make it a domain, I guess. Because else I won't be able to transition. So let's just do that. It sucks. Have to do it. So we're going to require. Attribute. Domain. We actually have to, don't we? Because, for example, for the other, those are already domains, so yeah. Type attribute. And that's actually like this. Type attribute, and then my login user. GKRDT and then domain. And then we'll have to basically let's have a look. We did that with the others. Already have a lot of policy, and we're just barely scratching the surface. Hostname here with hostname, so. We're going to. This stuff. I'll just copy this. And I probably shouldn't be even be starting with this, because keyring the think it was, and then keyring the here, and then we need to make it an entry file as well, an entry point as well. So the my login user GKRDT, and it's actually allow, and then the G keyring D exactly is an entry point file entry point. Now we need to don't out it something, and because and we also need to require a type here, type G keyring D exactly, because somehow this stupid program has some awareness in there that it's basically trying to domain transition to the user domain. Don't out it. It sucks. All right, and then we're going to have to create also types for example, temporary content. Because we know that it's creating stuff in temp. But okay, let's just see that later. Let's just see if this builds. Don't out it. Error. And that's because we didn't close that. Okay, let's install that. We also need to actually make that permissive. Permissive login, my login user T GKRDT, so that actually runs, and then as we module that, and then see where that gets us. The shitty thing is that it's still going to be running this piece of shit in the my login user domain, so basically didn't was no use in the first place to do it. Okay, let's see what we get. Okay, now we're getting all this stuff. Dbus. Let's see what ABC denials we're getting now. Now it's really getting ugly, by the way, but I already said that a couple of times. 1552. Added to allow. It's really getting ugly. So here we have XServer trying to mess with us. And we have XGM transition. That's weird. Let's just add it anyway. And let me take off this so we have this stuff here. We need to allow XDM to transition. And then we have here this stuff which require. So I'll just make an X server section here because we're going to get a huge amount of sections. Type X server T. And then we're gonna also have to take a look at user debug messages. It's going to get really ugly, fellas. It's going to get really ugly. Tail and Homer firelog messages. Make that 200. Here we have certainly debug messages to self. Getting into debug. basically running dbus, and we need to basically run dbus also with a domain transition. From now on it's going to be running all kinds of stuff. So it's been running accession, which is labeled bin T, which we should basically console type. So we should ignore this stuff, try to ignore this stuff. But it's running debug, so we also need to take out debug. Make sure that that actually transitions. Now it's getting ugly real fast. So debug dt. Debug dt, I think. And then basically debug. this is where you basically need to, how should I call it? Damn, now I can't get another word. But you basically need to control yourself here, because you see all these ABC denials and you basically get into a panic mode. Basically, because well, there's so much stuff and you want to basically see results quick. And that's just not going to happen. So you need to stay cool, stay focused. And be patient, because this is not going anywhere soon. Plus, so we're getting into the to the point where we need to require all kinds of classes that we don't have yet. So that's here, require type. We're going to make a require block here. Class shem. Unix read, Unix write. See where that gets us. That builds actually. But the transition, we already taken care of the transition, because you can see it, XDM did transition properly. So let's see, obviously not going to log us in anywhere near. You don't have to make any pretensions, because it's not going to happen anyway anytime soon. It's all about testing. 1600. Although we do get some we are advancing at least a little bit, for because we're now running dbus in the dbus domain. So that's something. And we have some constraint issues here, and that's so stupid. Okay, but I know what it means, what it is. A lot of stuff to be taken care of right now. So let's first paste this in the dbus part, the dbus section. So I'll just append stuff here. The bus, the EQCT required a type, the bus, the exactly, we already had that, don't we? Yep, we did. Default context T, default context T, devlog T. I'll just, well, let's just keep appending stuff. Kernel T. Password faulty is already there, so we don't have to do that. Security T is already there. Alright, and then we have to go to require some other stuff, likely. And it's just important to stay calm right now. There's so much you need to do. You just want to hurry, 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 get things done. But that's not going to help. You need to stay cool, stay focused. Okay, so as let's leave this the way it is right now, see where what we're missing, probably the sub file, right? But we need to basically, and that's just weird, make the user, my login user, DKRD. Actually, a process start, a user target, I think. Don't ask me why though. So let's just do that. See if that gets rid of the I'll make that a test. See if this builds. Probably not. We have permission sent to class unit datagram socket. So let's get that in there as well. We have a permission signal for the process class. Class process signal. Now it builds. Let's just load it and see where this gets us. You can do any everything in one. Go anyway. It's just not possible. Now let's see where this gets us. And the bus creeps out. of course, because we are not anywhere near. But at least we got rid of. it seems we got rid of the constraint for Gnome keyring the daemon. So that's a start. Let's have a look at the day, Debus day, grab Debus D. Debus Daemon. But here, it's also fine. So far, so good. Okay, let's go back. So this can be allowed, and this we just need to take it easy. So first we're going to deal with Debus, remaining Debus stuff. So we have this random device. So let's type random device D, isn't it? Yeah. And then use home.t is already there. So this should build. Yep. Let's have a look at what else. So now we have this GNOME keyring daemon stuff that we need to take care of. So we'll go back to the file. GNOME keyring daemon section. And I'll just add it below. And so this stuff property is also already random device. We might need to require random device. So this random device T, and then this that there. So we have the random device, and then we have capability IPC lock and process set cap. Just get this to build. Process set cap will most likely need to require that as well. And that's the set cap, but it's probably also a get cap. Your random device, we already have that one. And then XDM tell to terminated signal, and then we basically need to take care of this stuff, this user temp stuff. So we're going to basically borrow some stuff from this stuff here. And just see if we can apply that somehow. So, Tempty. You need to be able to append stuff to Tempty, basically add, remove stuff, Tempty. Then basically, we need to be able to dirs and sock files. So we have a dir, create dir. And we're going to give it a new type and then sock file. Like that. But we're going to create a new type for that stuff. And then type transition. So it's basically GKRD. So much work. This policy module is going to be like 50 or 100,000 rules, rules or something. GKRD, and then Tempty, and we're going to just transition on dirs, because that's just basically creating a dir, and in that dir, it's basically, and we're I'm just going to call this dir. GKRD Tempty. GKRD Tempty. Then basically, let's just keep this simple though. Not going to make too many assumptions, because assumptions suck. Sock file is just creating a link for now. Actually, instead of GKRD, I'm going to make it my login user GKRD Tempty, and then my login user GKRD Tempty, my login user GKRD Tempty, and then I'll need to really clear the dirs so that so create new type, my login user GKRD Tempty, and just make that a file type, I guess. Yeah, type attribute. My login user GKRD Tempty, and then I make that a file type. Keep this builds. Type attributes, that's not how you do it. See, then, even though you want to, you don't want to rush, but in your head, you're still, there's still, it's still not the same attribute file type, not declared. You're still rushing, even though you don't want to. That's just natural. You see all these ABC denials and untype user TMT. And you know that you still have so much work to do. And then you'll just start doing things that you just don't want to do. It's natural. And untype TMT. Yeah, that's basically just rushing. Yeah, I've been here before. This sock file, class sock file. Once more, not just creating an unlink, so I'll just take care of that as well. You just want to rush because you think that soon it'll log in, but it won't. It's not gonna happen. Not gonna happen, man. It's gonna take a long time to even get something that enables you to log in. Okay. What else did we have? A lot of this stuff is already allowed. And then blah 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 blah. Oh yeah, then we got a lot of debugs. Oh yeah, and we have this X server stuff that we need to expand. Basically, X server is going to probably need to reach the user state. X server. Where are you? So we have this read write. We're going to have to also take care of that here. Read, write, and then it just wants to read system state, what it does here. So we're going to just grab that from, for example, here, and just allow it to read system state. And then instead of syslog, it's going to be X server reading states. X server server key. X server T. Server. Let's have a look. What else do we have? Obvious stuff. So here, it's doing a lot of stuff there. So we're going to basically clear out our directories, so that we can see what it actually wants, because now currently it's still a mess. So that's what we're gonna do first. So ls all z temp, and oh, it's actually probably run. it's probably actually run. Run, and then user, I think it was. And then, it's weird. Seems empty. And it's all set home. My login. Login. User. See, it created a shitload of stuff. So we're going to have to basically remove that. RM. RF. Config. Get rid of that, and then all these. Desktop documents, downloads. Need to basically create a script that does that, because we're going to have to be doing this for quite a while. But after this, I'm going to take a break anyway, because this is just the beginning. This is really not over anytime soon. This isn't over anytime soon. So I'll do one more run and then I'll quit, because this, like I said, can keep going and going and going. Oh, I actually didn't build. Sucks. See, I'm going to make all kinds of stupid mistakes right now. Now you can see that it's all there again. Shit. Damn. Script this. Because else I'll end up actually deleting wrong stuff because of I'm not gonna do that. And it's all run user. That the gearing stuff created. sure where Keyring Daemon keeps its stuff. Let's see if we can figure that out. So that there is just removed, right? Link sock file, remove name. So I guess we'll see. All right, so just try this one more time, and then. Then I'm really quitting for this second because I can't keep going and going and going. 3-1 is empty. And logging once more. Still that same Dbus related message, I know, because we haven't allowed Dbus comms yet. It's still the same. We have some more X server stuff that we can actually allow. But that user temp T stuff. Right, that's basically. Let's just take care of this first. XDM, X-Server, where are you? Oops. Get attribute associate. And then just add that. Get attribute associate here as well. So that takes care of that. Okay, that's that, and then we have this stuff here. So it's still there. Is still something wrong with the transition? There's no. It's not transitioning. And that's probably because there is already there. Yeah, see that there is alright. Where is that stupid ass there? Is there some instantiation going on? Probably. Right, now I see. Now I see. So, there was something. a misconception. Christ. There was a misconception with regard to Gnome Keyring Daemon doing that stuff. It's not creating it in temp tiders, it's creating it in user temp tiders. Type empty. Yep. Let's see here somewhere. Where is the temp stuff? Yeah. It's here. So it's not actually transitioning on empty, but it's type transitioning on user empty. That once more. One more. I see also have a... It's still not going to happen though, but... User ABC. So here we have me sending to the DBIS daemon, to the system DBIS daemon. And then the system DBIS daemon needs to send back. Tail and 300 for log message alls, and then less that. What a mess. Have a look at the policy once more. It did actually transition. Yeah, it did transition. So let's just do that. Require class dbus send message and then close that, and then basically, and I think I have it in a buffer. No, I don't. Allow my login user t system dbus dt and then dbus send message, and then dbus needs to also send it back, most likely. But I'm not going to make any assumptions. Assuming is the mother of all fuck ups, humans, boys. If so, just so you know. Type system dbus dt. Really, assumption that's in when it comes to as a Linux, don't assume. Just try it. I know it sucks because it doesn't speed up the process, but if you start assuming, then things go bad. often. Okay, so let's see where this gets us. So we have 1640. And after this I'm really going to quit. So it's still Debus. It's still messing. And now not even TDM comes back up. That stuff happens. This should be allowed by now. Oh no, this is login D. System D wants to also read system state. All these programs want to read system state. So here we have XServ reading system state. Now we also need to allow Debus to read system state. System Debus D. System Debus D. The weird thing is, that I should have been transitioning to he was already. Send message to myself here. Let's just out it to allow this. Yeah, so it's sending a message to my own stuff here. So I'll just add that. My login user Debus DT. Debus DT. But I'm stuck. Dominic. Actually, so let's just init 3. Ah, should we shall. Init 3. Then init 5 And we're back, hopefully. Yep. Okay. Now what do we have? Now search ABC 1645. None. Now let's log in. And I keep messing up because I done told you. That I would stop. So cannot acquire service on the session bus. So that's basically here acquire service, and here these two mothers. This is acquire service, but I'm going to have to require that as well. Acquire service, because deep in my heart, I hope that I will be able to log in soon. But it's just naive thinking, really. Not going to happen. That's what I'm telling you with keeping your cool, don't panic, take your time, it's gonna take ages anyway. But that's easier said than done. Okay, that doesn't do anything good either. But at least I'm acquiring service now. I thought my login user DBSD was already permissive. As the info permissive. Yeah, it's so that's not my login user, that's not it. So user ABC. Something is trying to DBS chat to me. Nope. Okay, we have an acquire service again. Oops. This one here. So that's acquire service. Acquire service. Hopefully, at some point, acquire service. Make that. Install that. And I'm stuck here. Fortunately, I'm still root. Send Q to F2, and then in F5. 1650. Yes, hopefully there's no. Right. No hanging processes. 6051. Nothing. Still stuck. Annoying. It's gonna take a little while. So that's that stuff. User ABCs. Something is trying to interact with me. Message. Trying to send a message. It's trying to send a message to me. It's just trying to send a message to me. That's all it is. That's okay though. Should be able to send a message to me. I'm not trying to be an asshole, antisocial. I'm not antisocial. He can send a message to me if he wants to. So, need to get rid of this stuff again. See where this gets me. So we have 1653 now. We're probably gonna have to wait to 64. Oh no. Okay, so let's try this once more. Nope, no go. It's a no go. I thought I allowed that stuff. Guess not. Guess that wasn't it. Guess that wasn't it. This is it. Jesus. That's an expensive mistake to make. See, you make assumptions. You need to stay sharp. Think about what you're allowing. Because if you don't, you'll just do a test run for nothing. That's just a shame. That's just a shame. Okay, there we go again. 6055. Are we clear? Yep, well, no, we're not clear. But this is... This isn't a big deal. So I'll just ignore that. But still, no go. Stupid divas. But now, all of a sudden, we're getting a lot more ABC denials. Right. So this is where shit hits the fan real bad. Strange thing is here though. Acquiring service. Another acquiring service. Man, oh man. Really want to get this done. My login UDT. System Divas UDT. So many acquired services. Doesn't make sense. Doesn't make sense. Something is going wrong here. I need to figure out what it is. Because this shouldn't be like this. It shouldn't be like this. And there's just way too many acquired services here. What I'm going to try is PS out. And is there a user? My login user? Not really. Right. So you get all this stuff here already running in the dbus domain. So I'm going to just quit here. Because you can basically see here that a lot of this stuff, and I'll just grab my login. You basically see that the GNU keyring daemon runs in the right domain, and then GNU session not yet, still running in the user domain. DBS lines runs in the user domain, and then we have here DBS daemon and then all these stuff. These are all DBS domains. They all run in the wrong domain. In the wrong domain, of course. And we all need to make those DBS daemons. user daemons. So that's basically why I keep stumbling on this stupid issue. I need to take care of that, all these, and that's going to be a real mess. I'm going to have to confine each and every one of those. So yeah, we did a start, but it's just that, a start. All right, so for now I'll just leave you here.